As the population of Earth increases exponentially, new sources of energy that do not endanger the already collapsing ecosystem are becoming ever the more important. I believe clean and alternate sources of energy will be major fields of development in the future. Interested in this topic, I decided to do some more research. I'm Ethan Coe, and this is my 2010 project and what I learned from it. Many of you have probably seen this type of flashlight. It runs on manpower, but then I don't really understand how it worked. So I did some more research, and I found out that it actually runs on electromagnetic induction. When the magnet runs the coil, it disrupts its magnetic field and creates electricity. This concept is known as electromagnetic induction, and if we think about it, many other clean sources of energy also are. Electromagnetic induction is also the basis of many different alternate sources of energy. The windmill is one such example. When the wind turns the fan, it is also turning a generator that is essentially a magnet turning around a coil. This also is electromagnetic induction and creates electricity based off of wind. Dams are also another example. When the water runs through the dam, it turns a generator, which is also a magnet inside a coil. This also creates electricity. After these observations, I set out to start my project. My original plan was to create a bike that would create electricity and a shaker gen. But then as I proceeded and went on, I found out that this plan would soon fall apart because my knowledge of physics was minimal. I first bought a hand crank generator and took it apart to see how it worked. From this hands-on experience, I learned a lot, not only from taking it apart, but also from observing the motor and how I could create a resemblance of it. My first generator did not work because the magnet inside turned and spun around and did not move along a single line. From this, I learned that I should probably measure the dimensions carefully next time. With this, I made my second prototype. This worked fine, and I wrapped 2,000 coils around the PVC pipe. It costed $15, and when I hooked it up with a multimeter and shook it, it produced voltage easily. With this initial success, I went on to hook it up with an LED light and made a one-bulb circuit. My contraption easily lit it up. I took one step further, and I hooked it up with two LEDs. I expected it not to work because it would require a higher voltage to power both of the bulbs, but it actually worked. Although we were given months to complete this project, I had many setbacks. But if I were given more time, I would probably make a more sophisticated system. For example, I would put a magnet on the floor, and maybe if there were an earthquake, then it would probably power it as well. If I put the motor on a platform and I set it in the ocean, the waves would also shake the magnet around. Throughout my project, I had many setbacks. I did not set specific deadlines, but instead set lax deadlines, which gave me no pressure. Next time, I would probably buy my materials early. Preparing earlier and setting deadlines are important life lessons that I can use in the future. These lessons can also help improve any future projects in the future and improve it. This is my TED Talk, and I hope you have learned something new. Thank you.